In late 1988, Newsfield Publications launched their own software label, Thalamus. This produced a clear conflict of interest as the biggest selling magazines for the Spectrum and 64 were Newsfield published Crash and Zap. So, every time a Thalamus game was released, a suitably gushing review was to be found in their magazines. Hawkeye represents the biggest disparity between Newsfield's score and the actual quality of the game itself. Garnering the third highest score in the magazine's history, Hawkeye is the poster boy for the Shill review. Audiovisually, this is very good with a large variety in sprites and good animation on the main character. Perhaps the biggest criticism is the lack of a cohesive art direction, as the sprites and backgrounds are a random jumble. A pretty jumble, but a jumble nonetheless. But, as always, it's the gameplay where this falls flat on its face. Your task on each level is to find items until the exit to the next level opens. This involves pretty much running the level 5 times, as items only appear after the previous one has been collected. So you run all the way right for piece 1, then all the way left for piece 2, then all the way, you get my drift. This gets dull real quick with the action staid and predictable. You have 4 weapons available, but 3 have very limited ammo, so need to be saved for the bigger beasties. On release, Zap gave this 96%, which persuaded Kidney to save up for this magnum opus. This probably also represents the exact point I started turning into the cynical old bugger I am today. So, it's very pretty but utterly shallow, it would do a bomb on TikTok.
Thank you.
So, what happens when an all-style no-substance 8-bit game is ported up a generation and makes zero use of the new machine's capabilities? The graphics have been given hardly any upgrade at all and the sound is utterly uninspired, so this has to stand on its gameplay alone, and that's a massive problem for a game as utterly generic as this. Whereas the 64 version was technically excellent, the Amiga version is a cheap, outsourced cash grab which is not worth your time. Thumbs down.
I